Hi, my name is Brian Kelly. In cued speech, it looks like this. I was born with profound hearing loss, and I grew up learning sign language, cued speech, signing like this, and learning to speak orally. Those are the different communication methods I grew up with. I went through mainstream schools, and now I work for Lockheed Martin as a software engineer and project lead.
Hi, my name is Zane. I'm a high schooler. I live in San Diego. I grew up in mainstream school, and I mostly use spoken language. I know a little bit of sign language. The challenges I had to overcome was hearing in a mainstream school when like teachers are talking to you. But overall, it's been a very enjoyable experience. And I'm going to RIT for my college.
That's cool.
Yeah, what are your hobbies?
So my hobbies, because I live here in Colorado, they're kind of standard Colorado life activities. I enjoy skiing, mountain biking, hiking, off-roading, and just different things to do in the mountains. Also, I really enjoy traveling, exploring new places, learning something new about that place. And I just enjoy doing things outside of my main job with programming and software and teamwork and mediation that comes from managing a team.
That's cool. I like to travel as well. And then since I live in San Diego, most of my hobbies include just going to the beach and surfing with my friends. I went surfing this morning before school. Yeah, and then volleyball.
Cool. That sounds like California life.
That's cool.
Yeah, and then volleyball is taking up a lot of my time. We actually just got into our championship playoffs, so that's very interesting.
When I was in high school, I was a very good runner. I loved to run cross country and track. And I played baseball in high school because I grew up playing baseball and I enjoyed it. And I know my experience, well, because cross country is an individual sport, you're more focused on yourself. And communicating with the team is more about building friendships and team camaraderie. And baseball requires more communication with teammates, but you also need to watch out, like when there are fly balls. You have to make sure you don't crash into someone when you're both trying to catch the ball. I'd have to keep my eyes peeled to make sure someone's caught the ball or if I should get it. And I do that while trying to understand my coach talking to me. That's really what I did in high school.
For me, like a deaf and hard of hearing student, is a bit more difficult when you're out on the court playing and your coach is yelling at you. But how I did it was I just talked with my coaches and players. And I made accommodations of being like, if the ball is coming to me and I shout like that is mine, then no one else can go for it. So I haven't really had any challenges regarding that. I also did track my first 2 years, and then I switched over to volleyball because I wanted to do both. And I had like the same experience as you did. Like track was individual and it was easier, whereas like volleyball, I had to actually communicate real time with my teammates and coach.
Yeah, does it seem like we do better with individual sports because there isn't as much communication needed?
Yeah, it depends.
So, right now you're in high school. What do you want to do at RIT when you get to college in the fall?
I'm going to CS for RIT, so computer science.
That's cool.
Is that what you mean?
So, what motivated you to major in computer science?
Oh, I wanted to do cybersecurity, and I was looking at the requirements to go into that field, and computer science degree was one of them. So, and also, I just like hanging around with computers and technology.
That's cool. That major is similar to what my current job is, because I work in government programs, and there, cybersecurity is the number one requirement of the customers. And we need to know how to program, what kind of code is more secure for their information, and just need to make sure the software is very secure. That's what I do for my job.
Yeah, that's cool. I assumed that it was a job that would have a lot of openings in the future.
Yeah, especially because in government areas, cybersecurity is the number one focus for many different organizations because they are trying to keep the systems and data secured from anyone trying to break in and steal data from the servers and all that stuff.
Were you in any clubs in college?
Well, because I really studying engineering took a lot of my time, so I tried not to get involved in too much, maybe one or two clubs. I did try outdoor clubs for hiking, and I was somewhat involved with Habitat for Humanity, where they have different events to help build houses. In part, that was to help with the community. So, what are you looking forward to doing at RIT?
I don't really know what. I'll probably learn all the cool spots to go to, the dinner spots. And I definitely want to make new friends because I know no one there. I've heard that it's a very pretty place and I've seen it. So probably just explore and then hike, maybe like you said. I wanted to ask, what was the best thing, like what was your best college experience, your favorite?
So my best college experience was really all the good social time. Because I remember there were college programs for certain groups. For example, I remember a long time ago, A.G. Bell, the Alexander Graham Bell Association, had a program called LEAP. It was a leadership development program for people with hearing loss. So I got to meet all these people from different places, and I got to meet other deaf people who had the same experiences as me and talk about leadership. And there was always a lot of chatting and parties. It was a good time. And it would feel like being in a deaf world, different from my normal college experience where I had to deal with hearing people every day. It's a struggle in the real world. So to have that kind of program and social opportunity helped me feel like I knew others with the same issues as me, and that we could still have good communication skills and good, fun social time. That was my best college experience. And I made lifelong friends.
advice I would give for parents who have a deaf and hard of hearing child is to have someone in their life to be like a leader. And in mine, aside from my parents, obviously, it was my older sister. And she was hearing while I'm deaf. And she was a big inspiration for me as I was growing up. She took me to all my events when my parents couldn't. And she like helped me adapt into like the mainstream world very easily. And then I just immediately in elementary school, I made many friends. So it was super easy to just like, you don't need a massive group of friends to like enjoy and be happy. I just had three good ones and then my older sister, and that really helped me a lot. What about you?
I'll do my best to try to think back and remember. Let a kid be a kid. Let kids experience different experiences. You don't know what communication challenges they may face. So, the kid is just deaf, but that doesn't mean they can't do anything in life. They can do anything. They can drive, they can get a job, doing anything. The only difference is they can't hear, so they have their own unique way of communicating. And that's very similar to normal adults, to normal adult hearing people. It's just different communication abilities. And so I think the most important thing for those kids is that they have a strong self-esteem and a good sense of who they are. So strong self-esteem and knowledge of how to be an advocate for themselves and just to be who they are. They shouldn't be afraid to speak up or ask for what they need. And don't be afraid to be yourself or to do what you love or what you want to do in life. And different kids have all different kinds of life experiences. So I think that's the best I could say.
I was going to say, to add on to that, through my high school career, I talked to my teachers like on the first day of school and just told them that I was deaf, and then they would help me with any accommodations I would need. So I agree with what you were saying, just advocate for yourself and let everyone know. There's no need to hide it. That's a wrap.
It's a wrap.